Hi, welcome to After Before Friday, week five. This week I'm going to show you a bit about how to adjust your post-crop vignetting. The picture that we're working with this week is one of a delightful candy and biscuit shop on the Isle of Saint-Louis in Paris. Happened across it and it made a beautiful picture. It's not composed as well as I wanted it to be, so I took it into Lightroom, and I'll show you the steps that I took to process this photo. The first thing I want to do is crop some of the unwanted areas. So I'm going to come up into the crop overlay tool, click on that, and it is a little bit off angle. So the first thing I will do is I'm going to use the straighten tool, and I click on that, and it gives me a little cursor. And you find a line in your picture that you want to adjust the angle of the picture to. I'm going to try using it here on the top of the door. And I drag, I hold the mouse key and I drag it. There you go, to a line. And you'll see as I let go, it will rotate the picture a bit. And I think that's, let's see, I'm going to click done and let's see what that gives us. It's a little bit overdone, so I'm going to come back to the overlay tool, and I'm going to adjust it a little bit just by dragging the slider. It's a little bit more difficult to accomplish it this way, but I will give it a try. I'm going to bring it to about there. Then I'm going to bring in the crop just a bit, and I'm going to unlock the ratio. Because I'm not framing the photo, I'm not really concerned about that. So I'm going to unlock it, and I will bring out my crop, and I will hit done. There we go. The second thing I want to do before I start in with toning and the highlights and shadows, I want to come down and apply clarity for midtones because it's a little bit flat in here in the histogram. So I'm going to come down here, and I'm going to boost the clarity a bit. Let's take it up to about 50. And I also wanted to bring down the vibrance just a bit. And I use vibrance because it will also protect the skin tones. It deals very nicely with skin tones. I'm just a bit. So let's leave it about there. At this point, I will now go up into the basics panel, and I want to bring out some of this delightful interior. So I'm going to open up the shadows. Let's bring it up to about 35. That brings up the shadows, brings out the interior of this shop. And I'm also going to increase the whites just to spread out the tonal range a bit more. Again, looking at the histogram. You'll see that there is some clipping, and I want to see where that is, because if it's not in important areas, the white clipping will not matter as much. So I click on that triangle, and here you see the clipping shows up in the red areas here on the right and here on the left. If I go back and I uncheck that box, we'll see what's underneath it. And it happens to be reflections of the lights in the store. So there's not much that I can do with this to get rid of those reflections. So the white clipping at this point is fine, leaving it at the higher level, because I can't reclaim any detail on those whites anyway. So we're going to leave the whites there. It spreads out the tonal range. And I'm going to bring the blacks down just a bit. Again, my practice is to have just a little bit of black clipping, just to give it a little bit more depth, not by much. The next thing I'll do is I'm going to come down to and apply some sharpening. I have a preset, and let me find it. I'm going to do Sharpen Scenic, and you'll see that increases the sharpening to about 40. And the effect, it just gives it a little bit more punch. At this point, all that I have left to do is a post-crop vignette. And one of the things you can, there are presets in Lightroom. I'll show you one. Here's a post-crop vignette. This is a pretty heavy post-crop vignette. For me, I want to bring that vignette in even more on the couple and highlight them a little bit more. So You see that the amount is at minus 35. What I want to do is, if I bring this feather slider all the way to the left, you will see where the vignette actually is. It's helpful to start this way. You can play with it, and then you can feather out the border. So the amount is about right. I'm going to leave it at 35, but it's the midpoint. If you play with the midpoint slider, you can see it brings it out, brings it in. And I want to, here's the default midpoint in 50. I want to bring it in just a bit, closer to the couple. The other fun thing about the post-crop vignetting, you can also, with this roundness slider, if you watch, you can change the shape of the vignette. I want mine a little bit rounder. Again, I don't really want to highlight the edges so much as I want the middle, so I'll leave it here. Now that I've got where I want the vignette to focus, then I go back to my feather slider, and you'll see how it changes. It just makes the line softer between the shadows and the highlights. So I like it right about there. So there you have it. That's the end point. And if I, this is the final photo. And that was the original. Certainly, in my mind, much nicer and pops more and focuses more on the couple's decision whether to go into the shop or not. There you go. If you are interested in participating in the AB Friday forum, where these videos are posted and others submit their before and after pictures, please visit visualventuring.com for all of the details, and look for the AB Friday forum page for how to go about submitting your photos. Thanks so much for watching.